Hi, I'm Jason Roth, and I work at Microsoft as a senior programming writer. The goal of this video series is to help you learn SQL Server. With that said, it would be a mistake to start with the features or even the installation of SQL Server. There are two important questions to cover first. What is a database, and what does it do for you? If you already have answers to these questions, feel free to skip this video. Otherwise, I'll try to explain. To put it extremely simply, a database is just a location to store and retrieve data. If you've ever used Excel, you might be thinking that a spreadsheet is an excellent place to store and retrieve data, and you'd be right. So at what point does it make sense to consider SQL Server? To answer that question, let's look at a fictional Excel workbook that contains experiment data. Each row in this spreadsheet contains temperature readings from a particular experiment run. One immediate problem you'll notice is the redundancy of data. For example, the experiment name and description are repeated for each run. Any changes to the experiment name or description involve multiple edits to keep the data consistent. Also, there is nothing keeping the user from misspellings that unintentionally create a new experiment. A relational database solves these problems and provides other services as well. Let's learn more about relational databases by viewing this data in SQL Server 2008 R2 Express. SQL Server Express is a free version of Microsoft's database engine. We're going to use SQL Server Management Studio. When prompted, I'll provide the default instance of SQL Server Express, /SQL Express. I'm then going to use Object Explorer to navigate to my experiment data database. Instead of diving into how to use SQL Server, let's just look at the database and compare it to Excel. Database tables are like spreadsheets in that they have rows and columns. Let's look at the experiments table. You can immediately see that I factored out the experiment information into its own table. In fact, I've separated the run values from the runs. Placing separate entities into their own tables is part of a process called normalization. It reduces redundant data. If I want to update an experiment name, I can make the change in one place. One of the key abilities of a relational database is the ability to manage the relationships between these tables. Let me try to explain. This is a database diagram I created earlier. The lines show the relationships between the three tables. You can see that each run points to an experiment by ID, and each run value points to an associated run. These relationships do more than just describe the data. The database actually enforces them. Let's try to delete an experiment in the experiments table. We get a long error that basically means we're not allowed. There are rows in the runs table that refer to the experiments in the experiments table. In the same way, I could not add a row in the runs table without referencing an existing row in the experiments table. A well-designed database enforces the relationships that keep the data consistent and accurate. Now I'd like to quickly talk about two other benefits of a relational database. Databases allow you to create queries, which are really just questions. The query here asks the question, for each experiment, what were the number of runs and the minimum, maximum, and average temperatures for those runs? Queries like this will be explored more in future videos. Databases also help with application development. Development tools like Visual Studio provide multiple ways of accessing data in a database. This simple website dynamically shows the experiment runs when we change the experiment. Creating this type of application to run against our original Excel spreadsheet would be slower and more difficult to write. So with this information, should you use a database? And should you learn more about a database engine like SQL Server? Here are a few practical questions. Are you working with a large amount of data? Do you want to enforce the accuracy of your data? Do you want to reduce the amount of redundant data? Will you create web or client applications for the data? Databases are ideal for any of these requirements. And these are just the ones we had time to cover in this video. Databases also provide many other services such as security, backup, and replication. I hope I've helped explain what a database is and why you might want one for your data. If you do decide to use a database, SQL Server is a great place to start. For more information and resources, go to http://learningsqlserver.wordpress.com. In future Learning SQL Server videos, I will download, install, and start using SQL Server with you. Thanks for watching.